Hello, Klaus here, and welcome back to yet another video here at the channel. As you just saw from the opening of this video, today we're going to do a ghost effect. This is a practical effect, so there's not really that much to it, but it is a super fun effect to pull off. So let's get right to it right now. But oh, by the way, if you are new to this channel and want to learn filmmaking tips and tricks and DaVinci Resolve, and have a look at some pretty cool gear, I would recommend you to subscribe. And if you want to support the channel even more, you could join the Facebook group and let's build a community over there as well, or just join the YouTube members by pushing the join button down below. Anyway, let's get right to this video. So the first thing we need to do to make this effect is to do a clean plate. And that is basically just an empty shot without the ghost itself, and that's all we're doing for this shot. Okay, for the next shot, we are going to take a skull from some kind of a cow, and we're just going to, I have an aperture MC light right here. I'm just going to put that inside of this black cloth here. So we're going to make it kind of reddish. Okay, so we're just going to play around with the aperture light. So we kind of have this reddish color going to the skull. And for this effect here, we're just going to walk towards the camera. So we're going to take our clips and throw them into DaVinci Resolve. And here I have the ghost clip on top and I have the clean plate here on video track one. So we're actually going to just work with the upper track right here. So I'm going to select that and I'll jump into the color page. And in the color page, I'm simply just going to make a mask. Again, I'm just going to take a curves mask. I'm going to zoom in a bit here. And I'm at the beginning of the clip and I'm just going to draw in a mask. It doesn't really have to be the shape of the cloth. It doesn't really matter that much. And I'm just going to make it a little bigger here. And then I'm just going to go into the softness and I'm going to go to the soft one here. I'm going to soften that in just a bit. I'm going to the inside. So I'm going to make the mask a little more inside. And from the outside, I'm just going to push that just a little bit. And what I want to do now is I want to go into the tracker. We're just going to track our ghost here. And for this effect, the tracking is actually okay. You might want to change it some places, but not too much at all. Something like that. It should work just fine. So what I want to do now is actually I want to cut out everything except the mask and put that on top of the other clip. And the way we're doing that would be to right click right over here and add an alpha out. And we're just going to connect this together right here. So there I disappeared and we now have this ghosty here. So go back to the edit tab here and have a look. It's a little bit squared. So maybe we want to soften that out just a little bit. So we'll go back to the color and do that inside of the mask. So I'm going to soften this out quite a bit. Maybe also I want to add in a little to the outside here, little more to the inside, and I'll go back to this. So I know the shape is a bit square, but we could have made it a little more rounded and to make this effect even better. But for this tutorial, we are not going to do that. So with that top clip selected, we'll just go up to the inspector. And in the composite mode, I'm going to drag down the opacity. So it will be kind of, you know, transparent around here somewhere. I might as well also want to darken it up just a bit. So I'll go back to the color tab and I'm going to add in a curve. So the way curve works is that down here we have the shadows or the black part of the image and up here we have the light one. So I'm just going to drag in a couple of dots and I'm going to drag down this here and making the dark more dark. And also I'm going to do a little here with the skull. That's what we are working on here. And then we'll just go back to the editing tab here. And I actually want to add in an effect. So if I go into the open effects, I'm just going to write glow. We have here a glow effect, and I'm going to add that on top of our clip here. And in the inspector, I'll go into the effects, and the selected output is glow image. And actually, I want to go down to the color and composition here. So I'll go down to colors, and I'm going to make this, let's say, red, something like that. And in the spread, I'm going to add this up. In fact, before I do that, I'm going to go to the composite mode and add that to screen. And now I can play around with the colors and the gain here. So if we have a look here, you can see that we are making, if we use the gamma here, we're going to make this a little more like it's giving a glow of some sort. And we can do that in the saturation as well. So we can take off the glow effect here and you can actually see what it does. So it's making this more like a creepy ghost. You can do this with other colors as well as I did in the opening scene. But basically, this is how that effect was done. And of course, I would definitely not make it as square as I did because I don't think it is a square ghost. Anyway, that is how we would do an effect like this. Of course, if we want to do something extra as usually, I would put on black bars and I would also use the camera shake effect like I did in the tutorial from last Friday. So you can have a look at that as well. Anyway, I do hope you found this video useful. If you did, please hit that subscribe button, give the video a like, share it with your friends if you think it would help them out. And if you want to be notified every time there's another video on this channel, please hit that bell icon down in the corner. Until next time, keep filming, keep learning, and keep sharing.